Hey Orchard Kids, I'm so happy you joined me here today. Let's grab those Bibles and jump right in. We're gonna open up to the book of Mark, chapter 11, verse 12. Remember last week we talked about how Jesus came into Jerusalem and people were shouting, Hosanna, as he entered? Well, the next day after the big celebration, he and the disciples were walking back toward Jerusalem near the Mount of Olives where they had stayed the night before. Well, as they were walking, Jesus got hungry. Yes, you heard me right. Jesus got hungry, just like we do when we go on road trips. Remember, Jesus is truly God and truly man. Well, he didn't have a package of goldfish on hand like we do when we go on our summer vacation trips. He had to look for food around him that was nearby. So he looked and he looked and he saw a big fig tree. It had giant green leaves, and so he went over to it to see if there were any figs on it. Well, you might be thinking, what in the world is a fig? Here is a quick picture for you. All right, so as he walked, he got excited because it looked so good. The tree was full of leaves, which made it look like it might have some really good, tasty fruit on it. Well, it didn't. It didn't have one single piece of fruit for him to snack on. Because the fig tree didn't have any fruit on it, the disciples heard Jesus talking to the fig tree. He said, "May no one ever eat fruit from you again." Why do you think Jesus is talking to the fig tree? Well, he is the creator of all things, of all nature. And this tree looked good on the outside with lots of green leaves, but it didn't have any real fruit on it. It was created to make fruit, and it didn't even have any. So the tree wasn't doing what it was created to do. Did you know that we were made to make fruit also? When we believe in Jesus, he wants us to produce fruit. I know you're thinking it, Holly, how in the world am I supposed to make fruit? I cannot make apples or strawberries. Well, I'm not talking about that kind of fruit. I am talking about the fruit of the Spirit. Some of you know the song, and it goes like this. The fruits are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. He wants us to love and to serve him and to love others. He wants us to be patient and full of joy. These things show others what it is like to have Jesus in our heart. We don't do these things to get attention from others. We want to do these things for Jesus because we love him. We want to produce good fruit for Jesus so that others will want to know him also and to live for him like we do. So, early the next day, Jesus and the disciples passed by the same fig tree that Jesus had spoken to, and it was all dried up, all the way to the ground. When the disciples brought attention to it, Jesus said to them, "Have faith in God." Now, this seems like kind of a strange thing for him to say since he was the one that dried up the fig tree. But Jesus goes on to tell them that if you ask God for something amazing and big to happen, like maybe moving a giant mountain and throwing it into the ocean, then it will actually happen. But only if you fully believe that it can happen. Of course, God can make that happen because he is God and he can do anything. But how can you and I do something really incredible and amazing? Well, if we believe that we can do it and God wants it to happen, then it'll happen. He tells us that we must have faith in God and then we can do anything because we can. He might let us do amazing things because he wants it and he wants us to be a part of it, but it's always him doing the task. So let's think of an example. Does this mean that if I really, really want that cute little puppy and I ask God for it, then he's going to give it to me? Well, if God wants me to have it, then yes. But if my brother's allergic to dogs and he would get really sick if we had it, then maybe God would rather me not get a puppy. And I may not be thinking about that. I may only be thinking about myself. But God knows all things. It would be really great for me to have a puppy, but it would also hurt my brother. So maybe God says no for that one. And loving and taking care of my brother is more important than having a puppy anyway. But what if I want to take a trip somewhere with my brother and we could spend time together and I ask God for it? Well, God would love that. He wants us to spend time together. So maybe for that one, he says yes. God invites us to pray to him. He wants us to pray with great faith that he will answer our prayer in the way that is best. But we have to remember that only God knows what's best. Jesus also reminded the disciples that they needed to forgive other people. Jesus doesn't want us to have sin in our heart that we are holding against other people. So if I am supposed to be praying to God and focusing on what he's trying to tell me, but I'm thinking about my sister and how she took my rollerblades and broke one of them, then I have anger in my heart and I'm not focusing on God or what he's trying to tell me. I'm focusing on being angry at my sister and possibly getting some new rollerblades. So he says we have to forgive others and then go to him in prayer. You see, what's going on in our hearts affects how we see things and how we pray. We want to pray for what God thinks is best because we are supposed to love him and we are supposed to want to obey him. So we've talked about quite a few things today. So here are things that I want you to remember. First, when we love Jesus, we want to be more like him. And when we are, the fruit in our lives will show others Jesus's love. So the fruits are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Awesome. Number two, pray to God and have faith that he hears you. And sometimes he says no, but sometimes he says yes. But God always knows what's best, so we can trust him. Number three, forgive others. Sin starts in our hearts, so make sure we aren't angry and focus on other things or other people when we go to God in prayer. And then number four, remember that he loves you so, so much. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we love you so much, Lord, and we thank you for the way that you love us. Lord, we thank you that you sent your son for us. Lord, we thank you that we can be filled with the fruit of the Spirit, Lord, and we can shine for you in everything that we do. Lord, I ask that you be with all the Orchard kids, that they would understand what it means to live for you and to have fullness of joy and love, because only those things can come from you. Lord, we know with you, all things are possible. Lord, thank you for being our Father, our loving Father. Lord, we love you with all of our hearts and we worship you and we praise you. In your name I pray. Amen. All right, kiddos, don't forget in everything you do this week to shine for Jesus. Now let's get on our feet and worship.
From my eyes to my ears to my mouth and nose, from my head down to my toes. From my eyes to my ears to my mouth and nose, God made me so. He loves me more than anything, much more than anything, and I sing because He made me more than anything, much more than anything. God loves me so. From my eyes to my ears to my mouth and nose, from my head down to my toes, from my eyes.